What was the cause of Albert Einstein's death? Albert Einstein's abdominal, aortic, aneurysm, burst on April 17, 1955, causing internal bleeding and extreme discomfort. He went to Princeton Hospital but refused to be treated further. "I want to go when I want," he insisted. "It is impolite to artificially prolong life. I have done my part, and it is time for me to depart. I'll do it gracefully." The on-duty nurse heard him mumble a few things in German that she couldn't understand in the early morning hours of April 18th. And then Einstein died. Dr. John Osplesch, a physician and longtime close friend who treated Einstein on occasion, believed that syphilis was to blame for the physicist's fatal abdominal aortic aneurysm. Einstein, he continued, was a highly sexual person who loved the company of many women even when married. Dr. Plesch hypothesized that abdominal aortic aneurysm are generally caused by syphilis. Why? He reasoned, would it be so absurd to believe Einstein caught syphilis during one of his adventures? Some authors have echoed Plesch's allegation, stating it as unquestionably factual because it came from Einstein's close friend. However, multiple investigations conducted both before and after Einstein's death suggest that the link between syphilis and abdominal aortic aneurysm is tenuous. A 2012 study found that only around 1% of untreated late vascular symptoms of syphilis develop an abdominal aortic aneurysm in the descending aorta, such as Einstein's. In addition, no syphilis was ever discovered in Einstein's body, including his famously dissected brain. While these findings do not completely refute Einstein's syphilis, they do raise the question, is there a more likely explanation for why Einstein experienced his fatal aneurysm? Surprisingly, despite the fact that many historians are eager to delve into every element of Einstein's life, few, if any, have looked into the circumstances surrounding his death. Einstein's aneurysm type is statistically related to his age and gender. However, the vast majority of people who obtain abdominal aortic aneurysm have a smoking history. Only lung cancer is more directly connected to smoking among tobacco-related illnesses. In a study of abdominal aortic aneurysm risk factors in over 3 million people, smokers accounted for 80% of those who had the aneurysm. Another thorough study revealed that current smokers were 7.6 times more likely than non-smokers to have abdominal aortic aneurysm. The prevalence and severity of aneurysms are highly related to the amount of smoking one does, and Einstein was a heavy pipe smoker for many years. During his several illnesses, Einstein's doctors advised him to quit smoking. He only occasionally obeyed. During these brief periods of abstinence, Einstein would open a gift of tobacco, inhale it to enjoy the aroma, and then pass it on to someone else. But Einstein was always tempted by his favorite vice's appeal. He frequently relied on cigarettes given to him by friends. Despite the orders of Einstein's other doctors and second wife, Elsa, Dr. Plesch felt sorry for the needy, humiliated Einstein and provided him with an endless supply of cigarettes and cigars. During his doctor's smoking bans, Einstein would pick up cigarette butts from the street and fill his pipe with discarded tobacco as he walked to Princeton's Institute for Advanced Study, where he had worked since 1933. He had planned to travel to the institute across from the surrounding meadow, but he changed his mind because the street had more abandoned tobacco. Einstein tried to generate the courage to openly defy the prohibitions, but he was frightened of upsetting his doctors. In late 1948, Einstein underwent life-extending surgery to prevent his abdominal aortic aneurysm from bursting. The surgeon covered the aneurysm in cellophane. Einstein is seen carrying a pipe as he walks out of the hospital following surgery. Soon after, Einstein became a member of the Montreal Pipe Smokers Club, writing to the president, "Pipe smoking leads to a reasonably calm and objective judgment in our human issues." Smoking was a relaxing and reassuring set of acts for Einstein, not for his genius, as some writers claim. For Einstein's health and, ultimately, his life, this was a justifiable trade-off.